Alrighty. So if all we know is that at 2 seconds, there's 6 inches of water in the glass, and at 3 seconds, there's 12 inches of water in the glass. Again, we can't assume that these 2 seconds, we went from zero water to 6 inches of water. That's not what we're saying. We do know that at 2 seconds, we had 6 inches. At 3 seconds, we had 12 inches. Okay, from those two pieces of information, can we say how fast it's filling up? Mm-hmm. Basically, we know what happened between these two times, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
1 second equals 6 inches.
Okay, 1 second equals 6 inches. Kind of a ratio you're giving me, right? 1 to 6, okay? Is that how you would typically tell someone how fast it's happening? Mm-hmm.
6 inches a second.
Okay, since 6 inches a second, that sounds more like a measure of speed, right? If I asked you how fast your car was going, you wouldn't say 1 hour equals 60 miles, right? So it would be pretty true. You wouldn't say it that way. You would say something more like
60 miles per hour.
Right, 60 miles per hour, exactly. So we have 6 inches per 1 second. How did we figure that out?
So at the bottom, it says 1 second, so it's zero, but after one more second, which makes 2 seconds, because that's boom. And then one more second is 3 seconds, and then goes up another 6 inches, which three.
Well, you're kind of doing what I said not to assume, and that in 2 seconds we get 6 inches.
I know, but it goes up 6 inches a second. I'm just saying that at the bottom is 1 second, and that's zero. And then after one more second.
At the bottom is 1 second?
No, it's 0 seconds.
Okay, 0 seconds.
No, I forget. Oh, wait. Confusing me now. No. 0 inches at the bottom.
Okay.
1 second.
It starts at 1 second?
Yes. And like, I'm just saying that below that there could be negative 6 inches.
Uh-huh.
And then it would be 0 seconds. No. I don't know that part, but it goes up 6 inches, which would be 0 seconds after 1 second.
So how did you figure out the initial 6 inches per 1 second?
I looked at the board.
And did what?
And saw that after 1 second.
Okay, so you saw that this height was 6 inches.
Yeah.
And the next height was 12 inches.
Mm-hmm.
And between those two is?
Six.
Okay, so that's the first part of it, right? You took 12, right, like kind of the end. And maybe you thought of it this way, maybe you didn't, but you really did find the difference between 12 and 6, right? And that's how many inches it went, right? And then maybe you thought of it this way, maybe you didn't, but you took 3 seconds and subtracted 2 seconds, found the seconds between, right, the difference, and found 6 inches per 1 second. Very good, okay. How many of you did a similar thing? You found the difference between 6 and 12? Well, it went up 6 inches. And you found the difference between 2 and 3 seconds? Well, it took 1 second. Okay? Good? Good? Well, that's good. You didn't know anything walking in here. I asked you a question. You did your best. Okay? Now we have a little bit more of directly told you how we can figure this out. So let's try again for this class. Tell me, how fast is the water filling up? How fast is the height changing? So in order to tell someone how fast the height is increasing, you want to tell them inches per second, right? How many, from this level to this level, how many inches did it increase? Carter? It increased 2 inches?
No, it increased
3.
Eight inches?
11 inches, right here, minus the 3 inches from before, we get 8 inches. And, well, that's how many inches it is. We're going to figure out how many seconds have gone by, right? So we're going to take, what?
Five minus one.
4 seconds. So we could say 8 inches every 4 seconds.
Well, I did 2 inches for every 1 second.
Well, sure, why not? Because if in 8 inches, well, sorry, if in 4 seconds we've got 8 inches, that means that every second it goes up 2 inches. Or 8 divided by 4 is 2, right? 2 inches for 1 second. If we could say how many inches per 1 second, right, that's a little more convenient. All right, so we simplify, and it comes out nicely to 2 inches per 1 second. All right, questions so far? Does that make sense? Simple, a couple of subtraction problems. We have the difference in the beginning and the end. Or I guess the beginning and the end, and the difference in the time between the beginning and the end. Okay.
I actually got that one right. Proud of it.
What's that?
I got that one right.
Good.
Myself.
I just thought, control. You thought you got it wrong, but you got it right.
Yeah.
Is that Caden?
Why do you say it comes out nicely? It doesn't matter.
Well, it's a little easier to think about 2 inches every 1 second than 8 inches every 4 seconds. So a little bit more natural for our brains to think in increments of 1 second rather than 4 seconds. Not always the case. It doesn't always come out nicely. All right, let's, one final one here, figure out how fast the height of the water is increasing in this scenario. If you're not writing anything down, then later you say, oh, I don't get it. Neither of us will be surprised. All right, Avery, how many inches did the height increase?
5 inches.
5. And how did you figure that out?
Because 7 minus 2.
7 minus 2, right? Start with 7, subtract 2, there's a difference of 5. Let me scoot that over. Mm-hmm. Where did you Okay, so 5 inches, right, is the increase in inches. How much did the time, how much time went by?
3 seconds.
3 seconds, how did you figure that out?
I subtracted 4
minus 1. 4 minus 1, that's how many seconds have passed, right? 3 seconds. Okay, so Caden, this would be an example of one that does not work out as nicely because it doesn't come out nicely like 7 equals 1 second. We have to think in terms of 3 seconds. Every 3 seconds, 5 inches are added on. Okay, which is kind of just...
Like, it wouldn't be very nice if it was like, so if you divide by 5, divide by 3, it'd be like 1.6.
It'd be 1.6 repeating, right, per second. Might be a little bit easier to think of. Okay, I know about how long the second is. I know how long, like how big 1.6 is. So I can think of it that way. But we can also think every 3 seconds, 1, 2, 3 seconds, 5 inches of water is added to the glass. So what we've done here, maybe without realizing it, is we found the slope of a line given 2 points. In this case, the 2 points that I gave you were in a real world situation, okay? I could give these two pieces of information to you like this. At 2 seconds, there were 6 inches of water. And at 3 seconds, there were 12 inches of water. Okay? You see how that conveys the same information without drawing a picture? Yeah.
I was like listening just as well.
So, if I tell you that at 2 seconds we have 6 inches of water, and at 3 seconds we have 12 inches of water, right, and I want to know how fast is the water changing, well, what I really just did was I took this y value, and I subtracted this y value, it got 6. I took this x value and subtracted this x value and found the difference in seconds, it was 1 second. Okay. I do the same here, I tell you that at 1 second there's 3 inches of water, and at 5 seconds it looks like it's an S. 5 seconds, there's 11 inches of water. I just take this Y value minus this Y value, and this X value minus this X value. And then the change in Y over the change in X. Have you heard that before? We've been talking about slope for a while. Or change in Y over change in X, right? Change in Y, change in X. Okay. Remember that is the Greek letter delta, which means change. Delta, which means change. And to find a change between two points, between two values, we would just subtract, right? And that's what we did, 11 minus 3, 5 minus 1. Let's take this one and look at it on the plane. So they give you this information, I can give it to you this way. These can be represented as points, 1, 3, 5, 5, 11, so that's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 11, 5, 11. And okay with your line. Okay. If I wanted to find the slope of this line, I just need to find the difference between these two y values. Right, find out how much we go up. Find the difference in these two x values. Find how much we go over. Right. If I take 11 minus 3, right, that's where this y value is right here. 11, it's at 5 comma 11. 11 minus this y value right here, this is at 1, 3. 11 minus 3, just like we've already done. 11 minus 3 over 5 minus 1. 5 minus 1. Get our slope, 8 over 4. We go up 8 and over 4, which is the same as going up 2 and over 1. So finding the rate that the height is increasing, the same as finding the slope between two points on the line. Okay, does that make sense? To translate from like real world rate of change to graph and the slope. Avery, no?
Kind of. Why did it? Alright, so the first one would be 1, so you'd go up 1, but then when you go over 3.
Well, so you're talking about this guy here. There's a difference between plotting a point and using the slope.
Part.
Right?
I get that part. I was just confused by the graphing.
Can the answer be a fraction
first? Mm-hmm.
This
the last
is
one.
This is math.
The last one it was.
Okay, so we pretty much do what we did for that.
Yes.
Finding stuff.
Yeah.
Okay.
Instead of saying, like, here's 2 points, find the slope between them, I'm trying to show you what the slope actually could represent. Avery, did your question get answered or no?
Well, kind of. So like, what, can you just redo that plane thing? Like how you graph that?
You just like want me to erase it and redo it?
Yeah, just the graph part.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna mess some other stuff up, but that's okay.
I get everything except for that part.
So you walked in and I asked you find how fast the height is increasing in the water. And you just kind of intuitively said, well, it was at 3 inches to start with. It was at 11 inches later on, so it must have gone up 8 inches, right? 11 minus 3 is 8.
Mm-hmm.
And at the beginning, it was 1 second. And at the quote end, it was at 5 seconds. And so 4 seconds must have gone by. 5 minus 1 is 4. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, whatever. So the only thing that I'm doing is I'm taking the information from this picture and I'm translating it into data points, right? Just like
yeah,
if we,
I got that part then.
We were out in the world and we were taking down data in a table or something, we might represent it like this, because it's just a little bit quicker, right? Where X represents what?
The inches. Or I mean the seconds, I mean.
Right, X represents seconds and Y represents
The inches.
Inches, right, and x represents seconds, and y represents inches, and any other data point that I write down is gonna be the same. It's gonna be x is seconds and y is inches. So when I put that on the plane, I just plot those points just like that. That's our x-axis, right? This is our y-axis. X represents seconds, y represents inches. So we plot our seconds on the x and our inches on the y. Right. So we have an x of 1 and a y of 3. You go 1 and up 3 like that. Okay. And when I say over 1 and up 3, that is not the same as the slope. That's just finding where the point is, right? I move the right 1, move up 3, that's where that point is, which is different from the over and the up of the slope. Okay. Then we have this other data point, 5, 11. So we move to 5. An x of 5 and a y of 11. So that's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Let's throw down a point right there.
So the slope.
All right, that makes sense.
From point to point.
From point to point, yeah. Yeah, from point to point. From this point to that point, right, how much did we go over? How much did we go up? Well, from point to point, we don't go up 11.
Oh.
You only go up at 8.
So your slope would be 8?
Your slope would be, well, 8 is part of the slope. You go up 8 and you go
over 4.
To the right 4.
Okay, that's.
And we did that calculation here with a more intuitive model, right? We can grasp what it looks like for a glass to fill up with water. Right? We translate that to a graph. And it comes sometimes becomes a little more confusing. So I want you to understand what the slope represents. Okay? Not that we haven't talked about that before. We have talked about what the slope represents. The slope of this line for this situation represents the rate that the height is increasing on this cup, this glass, or whatever. So the slope of the line directly translates to what the rate of change of the height. Okay? So it's a positive increase, right? It's filling up, it's not emptying. It's filling up, so we see a positive slope. We see as we move to the right on the line, we move up. I should draw this line so we can talk about a line we've actually drawn.
All right,
so,
that makes sense now.
Good, good. So when I draw this picture of a glass, I think it's a little easier for you to say, okay, so this many inches increased, this many seconds have gone by, 8 inches for every 4 seconds, 2 inches for every 1 second. When I plot them as points, what I want you to understand is you're finding the same thing. You're finding the rate of increase, okay? And between these two points, if we think this is inches and this is seconds, and if you're ever looking at a graph and you're having trouble with like just y's and x's, you can always just think of the y as inches and the x as seconds. And maybe it will help you understand what the slope is trying to communicate. It's trying to communicate a rate of change. And since it's the line, it's a steady rate of change, right? Remember how we did that exercise and when the container got wider and then narrower, the height would slow down, would speed up, depending on how wide or narrow that container was. You remember that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right? But that's not the case. The height increases at a constant rate. That's why we see a line rather than a curve like we saw before on that exercise. And if I were just told these two points, this point is at 1, 3, and this point is at 5, 11. If I want to know the slope, we just need to know how far over we move from point to point and how far up we move from point to point. Okay. How far up we move, well, y is a vertical thing. It's up and down, right? So I need to find the change in y. Right, there you go, right there. 11 minus 3. And then I want to figure out how much we move over, right? How many seconds have gone by, essentially? 5 minus 1. And me again, we get 8 over 4 or 2 over 1. And the slope, these two slopes are exactly the same thing. Whether I go up 2 and over 1 or I go up 8 and over 4, I'm going to wind up on the same line. And with this last one, if I did not give you all this picture and everything and I just told you that anyway, x represents seconds and y represents inches, and I just gave you a couple of data points. What would those points be, for one thing? Talked to Avery and Tiana already today. Anybody else who can tell me, like, what one of these points would be, given this picture here?
Almost complicated several times.
Would be four and seven
at 4 seconds, 7 inches, right? 4 seconds, the water's 7 inches tall. Check. One second, 2 inches. Okay? Two different data points. And the thing is, what we're trying to do is go from the more concrete to the more abstract. Right? If I just throw 2 points at you and I say I want you to find the slope between those two lines, I want you to understand you could relate it back to a situation like this. Right? It could be 1 second, we're at 2 inches, and at 4 seconds, we're at 7 inches. It could be hours and miles. After 1 hour, we're at 2 miles. At 4 hours or 7 miles, we're traveling really, really slowly. Okay, but we can translate it to a concrete situation like that. And when we look at these on the graph, okay, 1, 2, and 4, 7. You look at the line between those 2 points, and they ask you to find the slope between those 2 points. It's the same as asking how quickly is the height of the water increasing? How quickly is the height of the water changing? So just as we looked here, we said between 2 and 7, that's clearly 5 inches. Between 1 second and 4 seconds, that's clearly 3 seconds. Okay, we can do the same thing here by taking this point 1, 2, and this point 5, 7, 4, 7. Taking the y values, right? That's going to change me. Tell me the change in the y's, right? The change in the y value. 7 minus 2 is 5. That's how much the increase in y is, and the increase in x is whatever 4 minus 1 is 3. The slope of this line is 5/3. We go over to the right 3 and up 5. Every 3 seconds, 5 inches of water is added on. Does that make sense? Do you think we could go completely abstract now? Just give you 2 points. You can find the slope between the two.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Mm-hmm.
Let's give you the points 3, 7, and 8. 21. You can plot those points and look at them on the graph. Not necessary, but you certainly could. It can definitely help you. You could tell yourself that this is 3 seconds and 7 inches and so on. You can look at it that way. Okay, so let's do a real rough sketch of this graph.
Whoa.
There's a point at 3, 7. There's 8. Something like that.
Whoa, hiccups.
Looking for the slope between these 2 points, which tells us how much y changed versus how much x changed. So from this point to this point, how much did y change?
14.
It changed 14, right? 21 minus 7, it changed 14.
Oh.
How much did x change?
5.
8 minus 3
is 5.
Okay. So what we have here, two positive numbers, right?
Yep.
Two positive numbers. Which, if this were the height of water, what would that tell me about the height of water? That is rising. What else could it be doing? It could be falling.
It could be like.
But in here, it's not, right? It's definitely rising. Because it goes from 3 seconds to 8 seconds, right? A smaller number of seconds to a larger number of seconds.
Uh-huh.
It goes from 7 inches to 21. So we're definitely seeing an increase in the height. Let's do this. Let's think about this. What if I did 7 minus 21? What will that be?
-14.
So you might think I've done something wrong, but if I do 7 minus 21, if I also do 3 minus 8, What's 3 minus 8?
-5.
And what's a negative divided by a negative?
A positive.
So they're the same. Okay? All right. Let's give this one a try.
Wait.
3, 12, 7.
Caden has a question.
2.
That's
two guys. What is
this? No. Let's do 7, 3. 3, 12 and 7, 3. 3, 12, 7, 3.
I can teach
here.
A lot. 7.
You can say,
oh,
7.
7 have gone by between 3 seconds and 7 seconds.
4.
4 seconds went by, right? 7 seconds minus 3 seconds. 4 seconds have gone by. Okay. Now, what did the height do?
Went down.
It went down. How do our calculations reflect that it went down?
Because it went from 12 down to 3.
How does the rate show that? How does the slope show that? We're not going to get out of here just because the bell rings if we're talking. Got it?
Because just like a whole lid or something.
What about the slope is going to tell us that the height of the water is going down?
The direction that it's going.
That's the line. Remember, the slope is a number.
Oh, the slope. The slope is decreasing.
The values are decreasing. What about the slope? It can be negative, right? If we're all paying attention to what Emma just said, then we're really in good shape. If we're not, then it's not going well.
I told you it could be negative.
It's, but we can think of it as ending at 7 seconds and starting at 3 seconds, right? The difference is 4 seconds. Where did it end? In the inches. How many inches did it end at?
9. -9.
How many inches were left at 7 seconds?
3.
9.
3.
Oh.
Right?
Oh.
Minus the 12 that we started with?
-9.
And what's 3 minus -9? And if you have -10, it's because you didn't hear me change this to a 3.
Oh.
But that's okay. Whether you have -9 inches per 4 seconds or -10 inches per 4 seconds, right?
Yep.
You get it. So the negative rate translates to a negative slope, right? Going down like this. Okay? So there you go. There's your homework. Have a good day.
I'm already done with this.
Wait, that's